get past that armor.
Thank you.
Hey, Miss Parvati.
Not today. Just helping this fella.
Wish we had some better rations.
I've never actually been in here. Seemed scary from the outside.
Interesting jumpsuit you've got. And by interesting, I mean suspiciously reminiscent of contraband. We pay by the finger. What do you have for me? Here we are. Birdie Cotton. Cause of death. Let's just say overwhelming physical trauma. Bert was the local preacher before Max took over. Always was quick to remind us that we all get what we deserve in the end. I'll just need your signature here, 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 and here. Got any more fingers for me?
Wish we had some better rations.
We should keep our voices down.
This is where the magic happens. Well, science. But it still happens. Hey, that's... I mean, if you need it, okay. Heads down. Nice.
A friend of mine died a couple weeks back.
Somebody's been running around town raving about a colony ship. Plague must have gone into their brain matter. Thanks. I'll see to it that this medicine gets to the people who need it. Here, something for your trouble. Nothing personal, but I hope we never do business together again. Don't want to make a habit of consorting with smuggler types. You do have some cheek on you. Lucky for you, I kept a little contingency fee in case you tried to negotiate with me. Somebody deserving. Silas, on account of him being out in the cold. Amelia, seeing how she's around people all the time. Anybody in the sick room? Oh, I'm an actuary. That means I keep tabs on a worker's living expenses. How much it costs to feed, clothe, shelter, bury, and replace your average human worker. Technically, I'm employed by the Spacer's Choice Department of Human Resources.
Wish we had some better rations.
Thank you.
Move along, stranger. We don't want any trouble.
I don't know you. Whatever you're looking for, it ain't here. Move along. Answers, huh? You must be one of those philosophicals. Already got ourselves one of those. Yeah, that's us. And you can tell Thompson we're doing just fine by ourselves.
If you're gonna start wandering around my camp,
know that I got my sights on ya. Over in the hothouse, tending crop.
Enough with the questions. No offense, but I've got a lot on my mind.
You don't know what enough with the questions means?
No, I'm sorry. That was unworthy of me. Lady named Zoe went missing some nights ago. Just up and vanished without a trace. Now I'm pacing around wondering if marauders got to her.
I've crossed off my share of marauders. This ain't about them.
I go looking for Zoe, I leave the camp undefended, seeing as I'm the only one of us who knows her way around the gun. Hence my dilemma.
Vex me. If she told anybody, they ain't telling me. I'd check her room, but I got yelled at for snooping once already.
Little ways ago. She was always obsessing over her serial dramas. Wanted to see what the fuss was about.
Could be. Dangers aplenty out there. No telling why marauders would steal somebody like Zoe. Got no useful skill as far as I could tell. Marauder gang just moved into the districts a little ways east. Their numbers are growing. Gotta come from somewhere. It's not like Zoe to go wandering. Figured she might be out scavenging, but that ain't exactly her talent. Can't imagine where she's gone. Hale's a wide place. She could be anywhere. Appreciate it. Honest. I'll tell you what I can.
Well, enough to know we never got on.
Zoe and Stefan were close. If anybody knows the workings of her mind, he does. She was lazy and thoughtless, but she's still one of our own. What is it?
If you're hungry, Stefan's got supplies.
You hungry? We got canid ribs, canid flank, canid snout too. Something I can help you with? You mean Zoe? Yeah, we were pretty close. Not like her to go loping off. Zoe and I were gonna watch the serials, as is our custom. She never turned up. I looked around, but she was nowhere to be found. You sound like some type of corporate fixer asking all these questions. Zoe was always obsessed with this serial. Masked Marketeer. A scion of Byzantium turns to banditry and teaches his marauder companions the wisdom of free market economics. Shame she up and vanished when she did. I had a surprise lined up for her. The other day I got my hands on a genuine copy of the latest Masked Marketeer. I was gonna surprise Zoe with it, but she was gone the next day. Can't say I recall Zoe ever acting strange. Well, except for her habit of writing things down on scraps of paper. She called it journaling, but I think it's just plain odd. Hey, I got time. I'll help if I can.
If you're hungry, there's meat turning on the spit outside. If you're bearing illness, find a place to lay your head down and I'll fetch you a poultice. Whatever your troubles with Edgewater, leave them at the gates and be welcomed here. Any questions, dear? That'd be the garden, dear. You're standing in a garden. Also fertilizer, so mind your boots.
Excuse me, Miss McDevitt? Sorry, it's just... You got such pretty trees in here.
Why, thank you. You're Robert's girl, aren't you? I remember when you were but a sprout. Thomas speaks of you often. Are you staying long? You should try some of my tobaccorn tea. I brew it in an old spittoon, but it's been cleaned. No, dear. The garden belongs to us all. Life is the gift of the universe, and the universe yields its bounty equally, absent of prejudice. Ah, cynicism. The privilege of the young. What you need is a little taste of my special mushroom soup. It'll broaden your mind, or at least your irises. A home for anyone who's ever turned their backs on Edgewater. A home for those of us with nowhere left to go and nothing to lose. So, like the spores of the puffball, cast on the wind and alighting on fresh soil, we put down new roots. My goodness. Aren't you just charming? Reed Thompson? You here on behalf of that cold-eyed reptile? Let's hear it. What's Reed's idea of peace, then? Make amends. Spare me. Only thing Reed knows how to make is a mess. Like everything else that comes out of Edgewater, that peace offering is canned. I and my own are living just fine out here by ourselves. He would do such a thing. The question is, why would you agree to his plans? Cannery's got a regulator. You want ship parts, you ought to rip them out of the cannery's guts and leave us be. If you're going down to the plant, You should divert power away from Edgewater and toward our end of the grid. Think about it. You'd be liberating an entire town from a lifetime of service to that odious cannery. Seems the sort of thing a hero would do. You've seen that miserable excuse for a town with your own lamps. Hollowed out workers laboring their lives away at the cannery, living off whatever scrap Spacer's choice throws them. You know that's true, don't you, Ms. Holcomb? Your father died of overwork. His heart gave out.
He was tired all the time, sure, but he was old, ma'am, and he raised me all by his lonesome.
Look what they did to this child. Lost her family to the company, and still she defends them.
I'm all right. I ain't so fragile.
That was unkind of me. I'm sorry, dear. It's not much of a living. Every single person in that town has sold themselves to Spacer's Choice. The company owns them. Body, blood, and bones. You've been there. You've seen it. All anyone ever does is toil over a cannery. They give their lives for some heartless corporation, and then they're tossed into a Spacer's Choice brand cemetery. Life in Edgewater grinds to a halt. The cannery shuts down, workers desert in droves, and our own little camp grows and thrives. You bring power to Reed's town and you'll be killing us. Reed knows it. He's counting on it. I trust you will listen to your conscience.
If you're hungry, Stefan's got supplies. Keep your wits about you, friend.
Oh, that's Thomas. He used to follow me around before he left the cannery.
Oh, didn't see you there. I was, I was just occupying myself with a little engineering. Whoa, Miss Parvati. Hey, you're, what, how are you? Hi, hello.
Are you, are things safe out here? How are you keeping?
Great, just great. I've been trying to keep stuff running, just like you. Only I'm not so... Wait, they didn't kick you out, did they?
Oh gosh, no, I'm just along with this fella here.
Are you from town? I mean, you don't exactly look like you're from town. Never heard it phrased in such a way before. I guess we're all trying to get our ships off the ground, ain't we? Sorry, I just wasn't sure if you were from town or if you were one of us. Something's been chewing at me, you see. Fact is, I've been, well, lying. To everybody here. Camp thinks I'm a mechanical genius, but I couldn't fix a busted chair. Well, because I needed to tell somebody. You ain't one of us, and you ain't from Edgewater, so maybe you won't judge me as harshly. You ever heard of the Young Spacer's Guide to Mechanical Engineering? Comes in a set of three. If I had my hands on one of those data pads, I could teach myself the ins and outs.
Those are good. My dad kept a copy with him when he was working in the cannery.
I know the old community center kept a copy. Should find another one back in town. If you could find me even one of those pads, I'd be greatly obliged. No kidding! Really? Well, which one? Look at that! Building a computing machine out of Spectrum potatoes, a primer! I'm just glad it survived all these years. I appreciate you going through all that trouble. In fact, I put aside something special, on the off chance that somebody'd search out those data pads for me. Sure, I'd be glad to take them off your hands. What's on your mind? Couple months. This camp's my home. People you see milling about, they're my family. At least I think of them that way. I owe them my life. Would have died in the wilderness if they hadn't chanced upon me, starving and delirious. We all left the cannery for one reason or another. Me? I was let go, mostly on account of my incompetence. I mean, I was incompetent. I couldn't even survive on my own. Grace found me, Adelaide took me in, I've been on my feet ever since.
You weren't incompetent. You just didn't fit the cannery. Not like here. This place had a U-shaped hole, and now it doesn't.
You could stay, you know. Here. I'd be happy to... I mean, we could really use... this isn't coming out right. If you want, Adelaide would make a place for you.
Thank you.
That's the last of them!
I don't know anybody who ever came out this far.
Thank you. Here they come!
Gone quiet. Wow, you crossed them all off, like some sort of heroic accountant running down a list. Teach me your ways. Hey, me too. But mostly because I just had my second dose of Adrena Time. I am so completely addled right now. You, on the other hand, you were a sight to behold. If I had half your skills, I'd be the greatest outlaw the coast has ever seen. I'm great at clarifying. No. I insinuated myself into their company, see? And they didn't seem to mind one whit. I may have bartered them a few boxes of Adrena Time, but yeah, I'm sure that's got nothing to do with it. I don't know. The vital processes that constitute the miracle of life are mysterious and unknowable. Oh, you mean around these guys? The Marauders wouldn't hurt me. They love me. I'm practically their queen. Yeah, it must be my natural charisma. I got kicked out of Edgewater on account of falling sick with plague and stealing some medicine to treat myself. I'd heard some outlaws set up camp in the botanical labs. I decided to throw in with them. Seeing as I always wanted to be an outlaw myself. Instead, what do I find? But a bunch of former workers camped out around a greenhouse. I couldn't just go back to the cannery, so I was stuck with them. I've got all the time in Halcyon. Why? Adelaide wants me back on garden duty or something? Thanks, but I'm not going anywhere. This is where I belong. I doubt that. Nobody in that camp really cared about me. Wait, you're telling me he's got a copy of The Masked Marketeer? Why didn't you say so? I'll take my stuff and head on back, I suppose. Grace is gonna be glaring knives at me, so I've got that to look forward to.
What is it? We didn't always get along, but I'm glad to know she's safe. What happened, anyway? You pretty much did my job for me. Least I could do is pay you for your trouble. Let me know if I can do something for you.
Any luck finding one of those manuals? No kidding! Really? Well, which one? Ain't that just ironical? If I'd worked a little longer back at the cannery, I might have found this myself. Two whole data pads? Be still my beating heart! Oh, almost forgot your payment.
I've been feeling pretty low these days.
Don't let the boss catch you.
Vale's a little safer, thanks to you. We pay by the finger. What do you have for me? Gil Antrim. Real name, Guillaume. Duly processed by a freelancer on behalf of Spacer's Choice. I remember him. I was just a kid last I saw him. Shame. Still one outstanding bounty. If you've got a finger, I've got the paperwork.
Almost lost a finger in the cannery today.